strange. Very strange. Very, very strange. Very, very, very.
What is so strange, Caspar?
I don't have time to explain, my dear. I must find Melchior and Balthazar. They need to know what I saw in last night's sky. Although I still can't account for it. Oh, there's Melchior now. Excuse me.
I know that look in their eye. There's a mysterious sign to be interpreted. My spouse, Caspar, watches the skies every night, tracking the star patterns as they move from season to season. And that's Melchior that they're talking to. They also read the stars. For them, the stars' patterns are messages from the cosmos about events yet to happen. Oh, and the third person there, that's their friend Balthazar. They frequently come to our house on some pretense or other and stay to take the evening meal. Balthazar is a healer, preparing salves and tonics to treat bodily illnesses, and also listens to people's dreams, interpreting them and offering guidance for troubled souls. Oh, forgive me, I didn't introduce myself. My name is Zeta, meaning the free one. My parents named me wisely, for I've always had the strength to make decisions and take actions with confidence. Well, there go the Magi. Some great plan is no doubt afoot. If you'll excuse me, I need to find the spouses of Melchior and Balthazar. I wonder if Lilia and Timina have any idea what our partners are up to and why they're so agitated.
Welcome to Allen Avenue Unitarian Universalist Church. We're worshiping together this morning as we tell an ancient story in a new way. In doing so, we celebrate that our congregation spans many decades of life, a range of religious beliefs, and a depth of life's experiences. We celebrate the differences that provide our liberal religious community with a rich texture. And we celebrate that which unites us, a choice to be guided by love and respect. Did any of the names we just heard, Caspar, Melchior, and Balthazar, sound familiar to any of you?
Yeah.
Of course, it does sound familiar to you all. Caspar, Melchior, and Balthazar are the names that the Western Christian tradition in the 8th century gave to the wise men, or magi, who came to visit the baby Jesus just a few days after his birth. No one knows what their names really were, but the magi were likely priests of an ancient Indo-Iranian religion called Zoroastrianism. During Roman times, when Jesus lived, these priests were recognized as physician astrologers who healed the sick, interpreted dreams, and cast horoscopes. They were considered to be wise ones, very knowledgeable about the world around them and just as knowledgeable about the stars. What do you know about the wise ones? It's hard to know what's really true about the Magi. Two of the four Gospels in the New Testament tell the story of Jesus' birth. Only one of them, the Gospel according to Matthew, mentions the Magi visiting the stable in Bethlehem. Since these figures are part of the Christmas story, this morning we're going to imagine the story behind the story from an entirely new angle. Let's begin with a couple of things that may be familiar to us. Lighting the chalice and the Advent candles, and then singing O Little Town of Bethlehem.
O
Please rise in body or spirit as we sing together hymn number 246, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
My spouse has been talking in hushed tones with Caspar and Balthiar all morning. I wonder what signs they've seen.
The stars foretell something significant. Caspar hardly slept after reading the sky last night.
Some great event must be making itself known. Through dreams as well, for Balthazar slept little. Instead, they paced the floor for many hours. They always do when divining a message in a dream.
Here they come. I wonder if they'll be too preoccupied to share any of their thoughts.
I want to know their plans. All three of us do. The meaning of my name, Tamina, is the strong one. And indeed, I am strong, stubborn too. Friends, let's hide ourselves and see whether we can overhear their conversation.
As we have told you, Balthazar, our studies of the night sky convince us that the birth of an important baby is imminent.
I know less of stars than I do of dreams, my friends, and I had a powerful dream last night. There was a long road leading to a simple building which glowed with a golden aura. Inside the walls, I could hear the cries of an infant. The crying gave way to a heavenly song, as if the angels themselves were singing. I awoke from the dream with the conviction that such a scene will unfold, and I must journey to that place.
I too feel the stars have been calling us. We're being summoned. We must find this child.
But where, in what direction do they point?
Far to the west, we think. Nearly to the sea, possibly the hills of Judea. It would be a journey of many days.
Well, westward we'll go. And who is this child, do you think?
Caspar.
Given the remarkable arrangement of stars, they are a king. A baby who will grow up to be a ruler of nations.
Well, it could just as easily be a healer we seek, friends. A child who will grow up with miraculous powers to heal the sick.
But Balthazar, if you saw a golden aura and heard angels in your dream, the babe we seek must be a holy person who can speak to the gods.
Friends. friends, we do not need the answer to that question at this moment. We need only decide whether to follow the star signs to the child and how soon to leave.
And what to tell our spouses, of course. They won't like us making a long journey, and they'll want to go with us.
Well, I mean, they can come along if they'd like, but as long as Tamina does not do the cooking.
How can they come with us? And why would they? There's no need for them to visit this child. Let us go alone, my friends, and let us prepare now. We'll take rest during this afternoon's hot sun and take our leave at dusk. The camels will carry us through each night as we follow the star signs.
Agreed. Let us prepare our things and let us include gifts to take to this important baby, whoever they are. We must arrive with generous tokens of honor and esteem.
You're right, Melchior. If the baby is a ruler in the making, the proper gift would be gold. I shall visit the temple today and select a piece of gold to carry with us.
And I shall select some myrrh, because that's great. Who's up?
Friends, you both forget, we all forget, that the babe could be a holy person. The only fitting gift would be the finest incense, frankincense, to perfume their robes and hair.
Since we disagree, let us each take our own gift. But let us make our preparations now so the journey can begin tonight.
It's an ancient story and a familiar one. Whether wise healers or ordinary people, sometimes we're called forward into a new journey. Many of us here know what it's like to be summoned beyond ourselves. We arrive at a crossroads with possibility laid out before us and within us. Amid uncertainty, sometimes it's possible to receive fragments of guidance. A dream calls to us. A random turn of fate feels like a sign. The voice of wisdom makes itself known to us. This is joy, to feel ways that feel right, to take a path that rewards us. Our journeys can also lead to sorrow, when our hopes don't come to pass, when the world's randomness seems to seek us out for ruin, when even our most careful decisions turn out to feel punishing. At these times, we need to be reminded of life's goodness and the strength that others may lend us. In body or spirit, as we sing together hymn number 232, The Hills Are Bare at Bethlehem.
Thank you.
travel without us? So far to the west? How many days will they sleep in the harsh desert, unguarded and vulnerable?
Well, I don't care if they have to eat sand every meal.
Now, Balthazar meant no harm to Mina. And Lilia, our partners can take care of each other.
That's true.
My friends, what do you think of their other plan? If this star does herald a majestic birth, there'll be a baby and a new family to take care of. And yet the Magi speak of carrying gold, frankincense, and myrrh?
What infant needs such empty extravagance? There will be a mother needing rest and a father to be fed. Sweet-smelling incense will mean little after nights without sleep. I hope this child's parents receive visitors who will care for them rather than bestow gifts on the baby.
We could be those visitors.
We could follow them as they follow the star.
Of course, we're no strangers to the desert, and we have our own strong camels. We'll disguise ourselves as Magi too, and bring our own gifts to this heralded baby.
I like your idea, Azeda. I was given the name Lilia, or Dark Night, because I was born in starlight. I've always wanted to travel under the cloak of stars. Let's go. Although Malkiar brings frankincense to honor the birth of a holy person, I will bring something that smells just as delicious. My finest cooking pot and herbs, a rich stew for the babe's mother.
And my partner brings myrrh to honor the birth of a healer. I don't have their healing abilities, but I do know something about helping people to rest. I shall bring a gift of sheep shears and the finest fabrics. I'll create soft pillows for the family and will weave delicate bunting for the babe.
Caspar brings gold, believing the child to be a king in the making. I have nothing so fine in my possession, but I do have the gift of singing. I shall sit by the baby's side, singing them to sleep with gentle melodies. And so, our secret journeys begin. We cheerfully helped our partners, prepare a bundle of supplies. Into Caspar's went a nugget of gold. Melchior tucked generous amounts of frankincense into their bag, and Balthazar's bundle contained jars of myrrh. We watched them load their camels at twilight, and they struck out on their journey westward. And as soon as they had left, we started to pack for our own journey. Where was I? Back for our own journey. Tamina's camel carried thick rolls of the softest cottons and silks wrapped around her sheep shears. Inside Lilia's bundle, the round sides of a cooking pot were visible. Now, since my voice takes up no space, I loaded food and a tent and all kinds of other stuff onto my camel. And then, with our beloveds still visible on the horizon, thanks to the light of the moon, we set out behind them in a silent caravan.
What gifts do we bring to this community? gifts we might share within these walls and beyond them. How little would it take from each of us to form a significant gift that might make a big difference? As we contribute to the offering, our ritual of stewardship, let us give of ourselves to the larger whole, not because there isn't need somewhere else, nor because we are a perfect community. Rather, let us share our gifts this morning out of gratitude for all that we have, and trust that our offering will find its way to grateful recipients. This month, we share our offering with the Minister's Discretionary Fund, which provides confidential emergency financial assistance for church members and friends. You can learn more in your order of service, the e-news, or by reaching out to Rev Tara. Donations can be made now as the basket is passed, through the donate button on our website, or if you are a member, on Breeze. If giving through Breeze, please note if your donation is your pledge or a gift to our Share the Plate. If you are visiting us for the first time this morning, please know that your presence is a gift to us. At this time, our offering will be collected and gratefully received. Jubilate is a song of joy and thanks, remembering the wise people and wise children everywhere who have set out on journeys of faith and courage. Let us sing our next hymn, voicing our jubilate, number 47, Now on Land and Sea Descending.
Thank you. like the Magi and their spouses in this story, maybe you have set out on an uncertain journey at some time in your life. What was it like to be carried forward? Perhaps you were unsure of where the journey would take you or whether you would be strong enough to keep going. Maybe your journey led you through delightful twists or delivered you somewhere you never expected to end up. May we reflect for these few moments on all the journeys that began in hope and in which our hope was rewarded. Take some time to count the forks in the road that once taken led to happy discoveries and to meaningful relationships. Know your courage and strength, which you have shown in making those journeys. Remember the moments of peace profound that came to you when the path seemed particularly risky. Ask yourself silently what guided you forward. Recall the ways you have experienced the care that cares for all, moving through your life, guiding you just as the stars led the Magi to that stable in Bethlehem. How does the care that cares for all continue to express itself in your life? May we rest in the confidence of changeless love, the Holy's love for each of us, our love for one another as members of a beloved community, the love that has held us to our journeys and carries us forward. It is told in the Gospel according to Luke, while Mary and Joseph were there in Bethlehem, which we will meet in momentarily. So while Mary and Joseph were there in Bethlehem, the time came for a baby to be born. And she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them anywhere else. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to those shepherds, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy for all people. Today in the town of David, a child has been born to you. He is Jesus the Christ. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." And so the cries of the infant became a heavenly host of voices singing. Thus it was that the Magi appeared at the stable offering their gifts. Let us sing together, We Three Kings, and please stay seated.
Thank you. Great things will become this child.
May they live long and prosper and know peace all their days.
I hope you like the gift.
Of course, they never consulted us. They were wise ones, kings, star readers, and we merely transportation. They simply loaded us with gifts and turned us towards the star. I ask you, what a king know of choosing presents for a child? Had they ever even seen a baby born to such simple folks, so naked of pretension, so open to the wind? What would such a child care for perfumes and gold? Far better to have asked one born in the desert, tested by wind and sand. We saw what he would need, the gift of perseverance, of continuing on the hard way, making do with what there is, living on what you have inside. The gift of holding up under a burden, of lifting another with grace, of kneeling to accept the weight of what you must bear. Our footsteps could have rocked him with the rhythm of the road, shown him comfort in a harsh land, the dignity of continually moving forward. But the wise ones were not wise enough to ask. They simply left their trinkets and admired the rustic view. Before you knew it, we were turned again toward home, carrying men only half willing to be amazed. But never mind, we saw the baby, felt him reach for the bright tassels of our gear. We desert amblers have our ways of seeing what you chatterers must miss. The child at heart knows something about following a star. Our gifts are given, have no doubt. His life will bear the print of who we are.
We were amazed. We arrived at that humble stable, and we were amazed to the point of being changed. Timina, Lilia, and I knew something about making do with what there is, and accepting the weight of what we must bear. And in the eyes of that baby, we saw that he knew too. There was no question, he understood suffering even at a few days old. I sensed somehow that his life would both relieve the suffering of others and end in his own suffering. We were changed by this child and received something from him even though we came to give of ourselves. And we did what we came to do. Each of us presented our gift to the child, to Mary, to Joseph. We fortified the new parents with rich broth and prepared them a comfortable bed in the stable. All of the other visitors had left. The cows and the sheep were our only companions within the stable walls. As the stars shined their light through the night, Mary and Joseph spoke the quiet language of love to their newborn, cradling him and cooing to him as the family settled into sleep. And I sang them my lullaby.
Please rise in body or spirit as we all sing together hymn number 409, Sleep, My Child.
Thank you.
Tonight, the moon will keep her watch over us while half the world sleeps. May we who are awake keep our loving vigil over one another. As we extinguish our chalice, may this pure and holy feeling linger in us through this night and the many that follow.